All right, Shalom. I want to start off by giving all praises to Yahweh Bashem Yahushai, double honors to the apostles of Israel, which are the apostles of GMS, Great Millstone, and peace and love to all the brethren, Akim, preaching his truth and all truth sincerity. All right. Basically, I want to do a quick little video, you know what I'm saying, while I got a little bit of time, putting your trust in man and how that's not a good look and how you're not really supposed to be doing that, because I'm doing this because, you know, this. It's the day after these presidential elections just ended finally. You know what I'm saying? We got a new devil. We got a real authentic devil in office now. You know what I'm saying? A guy by the name of Donald Trump who's actually adamant about being a devil. All right? Not hiding like that cunt that lost to him. You know what I'm saying? So, basically, you had people, our people, so-called Negro, Latino, Native Americans, which are the Israelites. You had a lot of our people, most of our people, basically voting, turn out and basically like putting out there that, oh, I voted, and oh, it's good to vote, you should vote, you can't complain if you don't vote, which is a crock of shit. All right, but anyway, want to basically get on the topic of basically putting your trust in man, and actually it's worse for our people because they put their trust in a woman, a Edomite woman at that. All right, you know what I'm saying? The Lord said, man, that's not what you'll do. How you gonna vote for somebody, right? What about the Lord? So does the Lord do you put any kind of thought to Yahweh Bashem Yahushai, the Lord? All right, and what you got to say now? So, cause don't get it twisted, cause the Lord was with Donald. The Lord was with Donald Trump getting in office. All right, but you know, basically, I want to bring out a couple scriptures. And, you know, like I have the topic of trusting in man, not trusting in man and trusting the Lord. But I'm gonna see how the Spirit permits. All right, cause I got a few things in my mind. You know, I want to get it out in a nice orderly fashion. All right, this is the book of Jeremiah, chapter 17. Verse 5, and it says, thus saith the Lord, cursed be the man that trusteth in man. All right, what does that mean? Cursed be the man that trusteth in man, because curse means that's opposite of blessing, and curse means that's a negative impact on your life, you know what I'm saying, leading to your death. But before your death, you're gonna have a hard time in life, man, if you're trusting in man, because one, what, man is always going to disappoint. Man is always going to not do what you expect him to do. And the same thing is going to happen with this devil Donald Trump. Don't get it twisted. All right? Because you actually had, people in this country, you know, Jake, so-called Negroes and Latinos, talk about blacks for Trump. Which could have been set up, could have been, you know, could have been paid to do it, whatever. But, you know, they're basically putting their trust in man. They're not putting their trust in the Lord. Nobody's saying, well, I'm not going to vote. I'm going to put my trust in Yahweh Bashem Yahushai. They're not even saying they put their trust in Jesus. They're saying they're going to put their trust in it, or in this bitch, or this fuck, either this devil bitch or this devil guy. You know what I'm saying? Where's the trust in the Lord, man? Where's the trust in God? God of the Bible that you so much claim that you believe in and that you follow. That's people are full of shit, man. Talk about our people, the Israelites, man. Reading on. It says, and making flesh his arm, all right? Because basically making flesh his arm means, like, you know, you're basically trusting in earthly things, you know what I'm saying? Whether it be Donald Trump, Hillary Clinton, the police, the Secret Service, your own mind. You're trusting in something that can be touched. You're trusting in something that could be destroyed, all right? But you can't destroy the Lord, man. The Lord is the destroyer, man. The Lord decides what gets destroyed and what doesn't get destroyed. All right? That's what he's saying. Cursed be the man that trusts in man. And our people have been trusting in man since we got to this motherfucker, man. Trusting in man since we even got to America. And now everything's supposed to change. Because it's supposed that they thought it was going to be the first female president. Like, this bitch really had the best interest of our people in mind. Like, niggas ain't been getting killed during this campaign. Like, our people ain't been getting oppressed during all this campaigning bullshit that just ended. All right? It says, make a flesh his arm, and whose heart departed from the Lord. Why? Your heart, your mind, your spirit, you're supposed to put that into the Lord, man. For one thing, the Lord made it. So why don't you put your trust in the person that made you? You put your trust in somebody that the Lord made also. And that the Lord hates, because the Lord hates Donald Trump. And the Lord hates Hillary Clinton. The Lord hates Bill Clinton. The Lord hates Donald Trump's wife. if she's an Edomite. I don't know what the fuck she is. She hates his daughter. He hates his daughters. He hates all these politicians, man. All these people in the Senate. All these people in the Congress. Democrats, Republicans. If they come from the nation of Esau, the Lord hates them, man. Check it. For he shall be like the heath in the desert, and shall not see when good cometh, but shall inhabit the parched places in the wilderness, and a salt land, and not inhabit it. So basically, you're going to be dried up, man. You ain't going to be worth nothing, man. You ain't going to be worth nothing if you trust in a man. You're going to be like a desert, man. You're going to be like a parched place in the wilderness. A freaking dry land, man. Dead land. That's what's going to happen when you trusting in man, yo. And to you Israelites, you so-called Negroes, Latino, Native Americans that put your trust in Donald Trump. Because a lot of Jakes voted for Trump, man. I actually heard that a lot of Latinos turned out to vote for him. Are you kidding me? This motherfucker said that you were fucking illegal immigrants and he wants you to build a wall to keep you out. Even though it was a crock of shit. But just the fact that he felt comfortable to say it. Alright, I'm going to jump up to the 7th verse. It's the opposite effect. You know, I said curse is the opposite of blessing. Here goes what happens to a person that trusts in the Lord. Jeremiah 17 verse 7. Blessed is the man that trusts in the Lord, and whose hope the Lord is. It said, blessed is the man that trusts in the Lord, and whose hope the Lord is, man. Because it said, blessed be the man that trusts in the Lord, because the Lord, what? Who hands out the blessings in the first place? Who hands out the curses? The Lord. So the Lord said, blessed is the man that trusts in the Lord, whose hope the Lord is. Because if your hope is the Lord going to have you be all right. Until we get out of America, you ain't going to be living the best of a life, but the Lord's going to hold you down. Yahweh Shimei was shy. It's going to hold you down, long as you keep your trust in him, long as you continue to believe on him. That's all he asks, man. And if you're a prophet of the Lord, and you go out there on the highways and byways, the Lord wants you continuing that, and continuing your daily, day-to-day, put your trust in him, so you continue to be blessed. Because once you stop trusting in the Lord, that's when you get cursed. And our people right now, they're in a cursed state. I'm talking about you so-called Negroes, Latinos, Native Americans, man. You in a cursed state, man. Niggas out here still begging for their place at the lunch counter, basically, man. Do you understand how much you are going off the way you carry yourselves in America, man? Don't you know that this land was set to be a punishment to you? What our people really should, if our people had any sense, all they would do is just go with the flow, man. And just wait for the Lord to come destroy these devils, man. But no, you people want to vote. You want to be all up in these Edomites' faces, man. You want to be, Trump, blacks for Trump. What the fuck? What? Donald Trump hates you niggas, man. Donald Trump hates you so-called Latinos. He hates you so-called Native Americans, man. He's a devil. He's a damn devil, and you voted for the devil. So the Lord's going to start cursing niggas, man. He's going to start cursing you Latino tribes, man. He's going to start cursing you Native Americans, man. You see what he's doing over there in North Dakota to you, man. And to my recollection, they said neither one of the candidates even mentioned a flipping word about it, man. But here it is. You motherfuckers were so proud to go out and vote. Oh, it's my right to vote. This is what our ancestors fought for. Well, it was coons too. And you the same motherfuckers that they fought for to start cooning some more. Alright. Alright, this is also the blessed man that puts his trust in the Lord. Verse 8, Jeremiah 17. Verse 8, chapter 17. For he shall be as a tree planted by the waters. So you know what I mean? Flourishing. And that spreadeth out her roots by the river, and shall not see when heat cometh, but her leaf shall be green. So what? A green leaf is a strong leaf, man. Green leaves are strong. It's a sign of life, and that's what's going. And that's a metaphorically speaking of a man putting his trust in the Lord, man. Yahweh Shimei Yahshua is your trust, man. That's the only trust you need, man. That's your only insurance you need. A spiritual insurance, I should say. All right. Shall not leaf shall be green, and shall not be careful in the year of drought. So why shouldn't she be careful in a dead drought? Because a dead drought, he's still going to have enough strength so he can hold himself down. He's going to be held down because he put his trust in the Lord. So when all the evil comes on this earth, all the evil comes to this country, the Lord going to hold that man down. Lord, when the Lord keeps the spirit on me and all the other brethren that push camp with, that push camp in other states, in other countries, he's going to continue to hold them down. That continue to trust and believe on him, man. That's all he asks. And to do all the stuff he asks in the meantime, like doing the works, you know what I'm saying? Being circumcised, being wise as a serpent, harmless as a dove. Being, trying your best to be as righteous as you can be. That's all he asks, man. Not to go out and vote. Not to go out and just be a proud American citizen. Go out, work, come home, and work and to get a better life in America. The Lord ain't say nothing about that, man. This is punishment, all right? Neither shall cease from yielding fruit. So you're not going to cease from yielding fruit. You're not going to cease from living, man. Because you put your trust in the Lord, so the Lord going to continue to hold you down and keep you lively, man. That's all it is. Trust in the Lord and be blessed, or don't trust in the Lord and be cursed. And right now, our people are not trusting the Lord. That's why they're in the predicament they're in, man. Only the Israelites, man. Only the so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans are going through any kind of oppression on a high scale, man. Reading on, it says, the heart is deceitful above all things. Why? Because people say, well, I feel in my heart that God is dealing with me and that that Jesus died for me, blah, 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 blah. Man, you don't know shit. You don't know if the Lord's blood is covering you. I hope the Lord's blood is covering me. And the people I love that do these works, man. You know what I'm saying? And if it's not, then it's going to be what it be. We have no control of that, man. We have no control. That's another thing people need to get through their heads, man. You don't have control over things, man. This damn devil shows you. And the Lord told you don't have no power, man. The Lord basically said this is the land we're going to be put to shame, man. As of right now, but we also going to get that fame. But as of right now, we're in the shame part, man. We on the bottom. We low, man. So-called Negroes, Latino, Native Americans, man. We're on the low level, man. I'm talking about monetarily, you know what I'm saying? Culturally, et cetera, et cetera. We're on a low level. All right? The art is deceitful above all things and desperately wicked. Who can know it? It says what? Your heart is deceitful above all things and desperately wicked, man. So if you feel in your heart that you think that the Lord is dealing with you and that the Lord loves you, I'm not going to say you're not part of that because it's not my call. But more likely, people saying that, man, you're so prideful, you might not be part of the elect. Because the Lord wants you humble, man. The Lord wants you low, man. The Lord wants you subservant. The Lord don't want no proud, man. The Lord said proud and arrogance, man, those are things he hates, man. Those are things he dislikes very much. And that's what our people are, man. They were so proud to vote yesterday, man. I seen it all on the internet, man. People on their social media statuses talking about, oh, just voted. Got my voter sticker. Here it is, the Lord said, curses the man that put trusts in man. And y'all put all y'all trust in Hillary Clinton, man. A freaking woman. A woman. And no, I'm not sexist. No, I don't hate women. But I damn sure ain't going to put my trust in a woman. The woman is a weaker vessel. She has been since the very beginning. It's not that serious, man. And she knows it. She feels it. The Lord's program is not really that complicated, man. It's just that the Lord just blinded people so much that it just seems like it's complicated, man. Sometimes you get a headache, man, talking to people, man. That's why I like, yo, nowadays, man, I just let people, yo, do what you do, man. Do what you're going to do. You're going to do it anyway. All right? It's at verse 10. I, the Lord, search the heart. I try the reins. Even to give every man according to his ways and according to the fruit of his doings, man. So if you're doing wickedness, if you're doing any kind of abominations, and you know better, and you know you shouldn't be doing it, the Lord said he's going to check you, man. And to prove that the Lord is fair, he said he's going to judge you according to your own ways. So personally, he's going to judge people, man. Starting with myself, man. He's going to judge me according to my ways. He's going to judge the other brethren according to their ways. He's going to judge the older brothers according to their ways. It's not going to stop. Everybody's going to get judged, man. And it could be a righteous judgment. But it also could be a wicked judgment, man. And along the line, when you live in your daily day, you're going to be getting judged, man. The Lord's going to put these tests, man. And the bigger tests are coming real soon, man. I personally think, just off the strength, I hope that after, all this election stuff done blown over, I think they're going to start getting it kicking, man. But I could be wrong. But I hope they do. Oh, this the beginning to the end, definitely. But, only time will tell, Oh, excuse slacking. Let me get another scripture. A little something. This is actually a little lengthy part. My battery running a little low. I thought it was a little stronger, but... this is the book of Ezekiel. Now, remember I just read that the Lord says he's going to start judging people according to their ways. Now, first he's going to start with the Israelites, which is the so-called Negroes, Latinos, Native Americans. He's going to start with them. Start with us. Judge us according to our ways, and our ways are... extremely fucked up. So a lot of Israelites, man, so a lot of so-called Negroes, Latinos, Native Americans are going to start getting judged heavily, man. They're going to start getting killed, man. Hey, man, you might hear loved ones getting killed, man. You're going to hear friends getting killed, man. Dying, man. Friends, children's. People you know, children's. The Lord is not a respected person, man. Just think about the flood. In a time of Noah, man, the Lord killed everybody except for 8 people. You do the math. You don't think it was no babies? You don't think there's no senior citizens? The Lord is in control of all the spirits. So if he's in control of all the spirits, he can control when they come out of the body and when they go into a body. All right? Now, for another video, Lord willing, it's already known, to the brothers out there that know and to the brothers there that's trying to know, that the so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans represent the nation of Israel and that this Bible is only for the nation of Israel. Because it says it all the time, but I keep reiterating it, because people just have this vain notion of what they want to believe and what they think it is in the Bible, what they think God is about, all right? But he's really not for what your program is, man. You're African-American, you're Latino-American, Native American way of life. Lord is not with them, man. You think Lord's going to come back and say, all the Negroes over here, all the Latinos over here, all the Native Americans over here? No, the Lord is not for this voting shit. What the Lord need to vote for? The Lord don't need to vote, man. The Lord is the judge of the earth, man. And he's about to put judgment on the earth real hard body real soon. Matter of fact, let me get this scripture real quick. All right, since I brought it up, it's the spirit. This is the book of Psalms, chapter 50. And I'm going to start at 21. Psalms 50 and 21. These things hast thou done, and I kept silence. What? Because as of right now, people think that the Lord is cool. The Lord is okay with what's going on right now because he hasn't, quote-unquote, popped it off yet. All right? But the Lord, he's long-suffering, man. Lord ain't got nothing but time. The Lord don't have a time limit when he got to do stuff. He made time. He made limits. He made boundaries. He made us. He made the elements. He has control of all that. He made spirits. He has control of all that. All right? Psalms 15 and 21. These things hast thou done, and I kept silence. Thou thoughtest that I was altogether such as one as thyself, but I will reprove thee and set them in order before thine eyes. So what? When he comes back, when he sends his son back, when he sends that army of angels, when he sends judgment on the earth, he's going to let it be known that, he ain't with what you're doing right now, man. Because if you're not about this, word wholeheartedly, then that means you against the Lord. That means you wicked. If you're not with him, you're against him. There's no gray areas, man. There's no in between. There's no way you can say, I believe in God, but, I'm going to go ahead and vote because, it's the right thing to do. Says who? Says the same niggas that used to beat your ass? Hundreds of years ago, the same motherfuckers that brought your asses over here in cargo slave ships, the same people that said being dark is a curse, the same people that call you a nigga, call you a spick, call you a Native American, destroy your homes, shoot down your men, rape your women, kill your children, those people, those are the people that said it's all right to vote, it's right to vote, right thing to vote, your oppressors, are you kidding me? That's why the Lord said when he comes back, man, he's going to show you how fucking incorrect you are with the way your life you was leading, man. talking you so-called Negroes, you Latinos, you Native Americans, man. Because even though you're in a fucked up state, man, you still are the chosen people of God. Yahweh Bashim Yahushai. That will never change. But as of right now, most of you is on the shit list and got to come back on the right list. Do the elect men. Do the elect men's loins. The nation's going to come back. But as of right now, a lot of our people are set for judgment, man, and cruel, harsh judgment. The Lord don't care about if it's your mother. The Lord don't care if it's your father, your little sister, your daughter, your nephew, your niece, your cousin. Everybody's somebody's brother. Everybody's somebody's niece. Everybody's somebody's cousin. The Lord don't give a fuck about that shit, man. The Lord said, curses the man that put his trust in man. The Lord want his props. People always say, well, be thankful that you woke up. Well, do you thank the Lord that you woke up? Or you just say it? And that's in the scripture too, saying that, oh, they basically pleases with their lips, man. But their actions say otherwise, man. YOLO. Alright? I'm going to read that again. Psalms 50 and 21. These things has thou done, and I kept silence. So the Lord ain't exactly get it real going yet, but he will. Because people say, well, I actually know people that say that they think they're saved already. That they think, well, God died for my sins, so I'm good. I'm gold. I'm Gucci. Nigga, you ain't Gucci. How you Gucci when the Lord ain't come back yet and cast judgment? He's casting judgment piece by piece, small pieces right now, but the dosage is getting bigger of judgment on the earth, man. Don't get it twisted, man. The Lord is not slack concerning his judgments. And you're going to find out real soon. It's going to get deeper. These things hast thou known, and I kept silence. Thou thoughtest that I was altogether such and one as thyself. So people think that the Lord is about what they're about. They think the Lord accept homosexuals. They think the Lord accept adulterers, adulteresses, idolaters. When you read this book, that's all the things the Lord is against, man. So if the Lord said, cursed be the man that trusts a man, how the fuck is the Lord about voting? Because when you vote, what are you saying? What are you stating? You're stating that you're putting your trust in this person to help your life get better in America. That's basically what you're doing when you're saying you're voting. You're putting your trust in whatever candidate you're going to vote for so he or she, you're going to get your life better. Put your life in a different direction, a better direction. And he said, what? But I will reprove thee. So he gonna start checking motherfuckers. Excuse my French. But I will reprove thee and set them in order before thy eyes. So he's going to let, real quick, he's going to let it be, he's going to set things back in their proper state, man. He's going to lay that chastising rod down, and Jake going to know real soon, like, damn, man, I was wrong all the time, man. Those crazy niggas with no shape-ups and dresses and all whatever that was on the streets, those were really men of the Lord, and the people we were listening to were full of shit, were wolves in sheep's clothing. Yeah. And we tell you that now, but you know, they don't believe young niggas. They either believe white people, or you gotta be a famous nigga. That's the only word that Jake takes to heart. Takes it and takes heed to it. But if you just some regular nigga on the streets, blah, 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 man, and niggas ain't gonna listen. But you will listen eventually. Now consider this, ye that forgot God. What? Now they told it to the Israelites, because the Lord don't care about these other heathens. They got their gods, man. They got their gods already. They're vain, dumb idols and gods. The Lord's worried about you, Israelites. That's what the Lord cares about. And you forgot him. You forgot the Lord. You forgot the Lord that delivered you out of the first Egypt, man. Now he got to deliver you again. Some of you might it's going to be through death, but you're going to see also the righteous be saved and delivered, man. You might see somebody you know that you might have talked shit about, or that you quote unquote didn't like so much. You won't see that he got saved because he was doing his thing, preaching the word, carrying himself as righteously as he could have, and you was out here bullshitting, popping mollies, partying, popping other dudes' women, worshiping these idols, worshiping these fucking vain individuals, putting your trust in Hillary Clinton. Put your trust in Donald Trump's. Alright? It says, now consider this, ye that forgot God, lest I tear you in pieces. Oh, but I thought the Lord was about peace. Non-violence. Non-violence, right? But he said, I'll tear you into pieces. Now, is he going to tear you into pieces softly and kindly? Is he going to tear you in pieces gently? No, man, he's going to tear you in pieces rough. The Lord's going to get down, and he's going to get down in a rough manner, man. The Lord is an austere man. The Lord is a man of war, man. So his son is a man of war. His prophets are men of war. All his diligence, all people that he got out there that's trusting in him, they're all warriors, man. Whether it be spiritually, physically, or spiritually and physically. All right? It says, whoso offer praise glorifies me, and to him that order of his conversation are right, will I show the salvation of God. So, like I said before, through the Spirit, those men that trust in the Lord, those people that trust in the Lord, they're going to be saved, and they're going to be saved publicly. And when we read it again, it says, whoso offer praise glorifies me. So you offering praise, you're glorifying Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai. That's why you say, all praises to Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai. All praises. All your thanking should go to the Lord. And if you do thank, man, you say, through the Spirit of the Lord, I thank you. But long story short, the Lord always comes first, man. And that's what he's clearly showing that our people are not doing. When you go out and vote, because like, When niggas went out to vote, and the niggas was happy to do it. It's crazy, cause like people were really like, yo, I just got back from the polls. It wasn't too crowded, you know what I'm saying? But like, I vote. I feel good about myself. Here it is. The Lord told you not to put your trust in man, and you talk about how good you feel about voting for some devil to help your life get better. You see the simplicity. You see the hypocrisy. All right, and real quick, just to prove, real quick, to prove that all the nation sin, but the Lord chose a remnant of Israelites to be saved, and a mostly other remnant that's going to be destroyed. Bear with me. This is the book of Romans, chapter 3, verse 23. This is Paul speaking. For all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. Now what? That's talking about the Israelites that's come short to the glory of God, man. Because the heathen, man, the Lord, he said they're nothing. They're nothing. They're less than nothing. No, he said they're nothing, less than nothing, and vanity, man. And I believe in the book of Isaiah chapter 40. But the Lord is worried about the Israelites. The Lord says that ye have I known. Talk about the Israelites. You have forsaken me. The Lord never forsook us. Because if he did forsake us, he wouldn't even cast judgment. He would just let us go on about our way. But ever since Egypt and after, we've just been going off. And the Lord has been jacking us up. And we're going to continue to get jacked up until the Lord has his elect gathered. And get us the hell out of here, man. That's what we need. That's what we hoping for, man. That's what we waiting for. I had a couple other scriptures. Oh yeah, that's right. This is the book Ezekiel chapter 5, and you know what? I'll start at 5. Now, mind you, we already know that the Lord chose the nation of Israel, and the Israelites are the so-called Negroes, Latinos, Native Americans. I got to keep reiterating that because you got to keep saying it because we've been brainwashed to believe that we ain't shit. But the Lord said that we the top nation on the planet Earth, and we always will be, always have been. Ezekiel chapter 5, verse 5. Thus saith the Lord God, this is Jerusalem. I have set in the midst of the nations and countries that are round about her. Now he's comparing the nation of Israel to a woman. But it's really the nation of men, women, and children of the Israelites, of Jacob. Verse 6. And she have changed my judgment into wickedness more than the nations, and my statutes more than the country that are round about her. So now we became like worse than the heathens by the things we do, man. Put our trust in Donald Trump's and Hillary Clinton's and all these fucking politicians and governors and lawyers. Men, putting trust in men. Which the Lord expressly forbid not to do, because if you did it, you're cursed. And that's what our people are doing now, trusting in men and being cursed. It says, for they have refused my judgments and my statutes, they have not walked in them. They have refused my judgments, my statutes, and not walked, they have not walked in them. So the same statutes that Yahweh Bashem Yahushua gave to Moses, he gave to the Israelites, these are the same statutes that they just said, you know what, we don't want to mess with that. We're going to go ahead and do our own thing. We're going to follow the Constitution. You know what I'm saying? But here it is, that this is what gives you power in life, and you choose rather darkness and death. Verse 7, therefore thus saith the Lord God, because you multiply more than the nations that are round about you, so that goes to the separation of Israel and the other nations. Continue, it says, therefore thus saith the Lord God, because you multiply more than the nations that are round about you, and have not walked in my statutes, neither have kept my judgments, neither have done according to the judgments of the nations that are round about you. So like, we're supposed to continue in the law, statutes, commandments that was given to Moses. But what we doing? We're doing things around in the midst of these other nations. So that's why we the laughing stock of the world, the Israelites. That's why the black man is the butt of every joke. The Latino man is the butt of every joke. The Native American man is the butt of every joke. And we're going to continue to be the butt of these jokes until we get our butts in line, man. But only the elect are going to get in line. But, you know, that's the deal. You know what I'm saying? It says, verse 8, therefore, thus saith the Lord God, behold, I, even I, am against thee, and will execute judgments in the midst of thee in the sight of the nation. So what? So that's what the Lord is in charge of this, man. The Lord God is being the butt of every joke. Why? Because we went not in the way of his judgments. Went not in the way of his statutes. So that's why the Lord said he against us right now, man. And when you went out to vote, you people in the polls of the so-called Negroes, Latinos, Native Americans, just know that the Lord was against you doing that, man. Because in the book of Daniel, chapter 2, verse 21, the Lord said he set up kings and he removed kings. So the Lord set up Donald Trump, bitch ass, man. The Lord set him up just so he could basically, because these elections weren't for you niggas. It wasn't for you spicks. Wasn't for you tomahawks. It was for these white people to feel proud again. That's what it's about white supremacy. Because what? The Lord said, the pride of thy heart have deceived thee. He couldn't have Esau out here all distraught. Because Jake was happy, because Jake would have been happy if Hillary got in. But the Lord had to put Esau back on a heart in their hearts, so to speak. Just like he did with Pharaoh back in Egypt. Put Donald Trump as in to make him feel like, this is how we're supposed to be. Because what? The way the leaders are, the way of the people. And since that's his people, these Edomites, so-called white people, the Lord put this Donald Trump guy in office just so they could, what's the word I want to use? Basically pump themselves up some more, man. Of that pride. It wasn't for you. This is a whole bigger picture that our people are just not seeing, man. Even these Edomites, they don't see it, man. They don't see that they're closer to their destruction than they even know. Alright? And I will do in thee that which I have not done, and whereunto I will not do any more the like, because of all thine abominations. So that goes to prove also, like in the book of Lamentations, the fourth chapter, that this is the last hurrah of slavery for us, man. And since it is the last, you saved the best for last, and technically it's going to be the worst for last, because this is going to be the most harshest, the most cruelest, man. The Lord's about to get down, man. The Lord's going to get down, and he ain't going to stop until it's time to stop. So, you know, with that, I want to say all praise to Yahweh Bashem Yahushai. Double honors to the apostles of Israel, which are the apostles of Great Millstone. Peace and love to all the brethren preaching his truth and all truth sincerity. All right, keep fighting. We just got to stay strong. Keep praying. Fasting, doing whatever you do. Trying your best to be as righteous as you could be. But keep those prayers in mind, man. Put those curses up too, man. You know what I'm saying? But continue in the Lord's Prayer, man. And Lashwan Kadosh. No, keep putting them prayers up in that Hebrew tongue, man. Cause we need more strength, man. Cause the devil's about to roll, man. The devil's about to get it in, man. You see they just put in office. This Edomite woman was saying that you can't Like, it's the first time you've seen a president that perpetrates anger and such cruelness, man. But you know what? That's good, man. That's good that Donald Trump got in there, man. So now our people can start seeing those horns of these devils, man. The same horns that they had when they brought you niggas over in cargo slave ships, all right? But I'm not going to rant anymore, all right? You know, brother, stay strong. You know, America, you're through. You Edomites, you so-called, you elite people that you just put your little puppet in there. You're still through. You're still going into slavery. Ain't nothing changed. You can do what you want. Do as many rituals as you want. Pass as many legislations. Make as many regulations, laws. Hire the taxes. It's all cool. It's fucked up. But just know that that's more on your tab of destruction. That's more your tab of slavery, man. Because we about to get you in slavery, man. The Lord about to get his just due. Yahweh Bashim El Shai about to put in that work. And mind you, he made work. So, you know what I mean? With that, you know, all praise to Yahweh Bashim El Shai. Peace and love to all the brethren preaching the truth and all truth and sincerity.